Jerry, thanks so much for being with us. When you hear Donald Trump refer to Elizabeth Warren as Pocahontas, when he calls Secretary Clinton a lowlife, do you take issue with that at all? Is that a Christian thing to do, in your opinion?
Well, I'm president of a university. We have a Division I football team, and we have lots of players who might have relatives or friends on opposing teams, but when the whistle blows, it's every man for himself. And I think politics is the same way. And I think it's the way the game is played. It's a blood sport. And I wouldn't expect anything less from somebody who wants to win the presidency.
I know you say that people should stop trying to choose political leaders who they believe are the most godly, because only God knows people's hearts. What about judging right. candidates according to their actions? I mean, isn't that really the only way to assess who a candidate is, what they actually believe in?
No, I think the way to assess a candidate is their experience. I think with Donald Trump, his experience and success in the private sector is one of the reasons I chose to support him, because I've been president. Before that, I was general counsel of a university that was in financial trouble in the 80s and 90s, and we brought in the best experts to make it the most prosperous university in the country now, one of the most prosperous, I should say. And it's, I think the country needs the same type of, I think the country needs a doctor who has the cure for America's ills. I think we're at a turning point. I think we could lose our country if we don't choose the right president this time. And I think Donald Trump is the man for this point in history.
I wonder what you worked obviously closely with your dad, who founded the Moral Majority. What do you think he would have made of Donald Trump?
I think he was roundly criticized for supporting Ronald Reagan over Jimmy Carter, who was a Southern Baptist Sunday sure. school teacher. Ronald Reagan was a Hollywood actor who had been divorced, remarried. Everybody said my dad was an apostate for supporting somebody like Reagan. But Reagan turned out to be a much better president for issues that Christians were concerned about than Jimmy Carter was. And I think you have to look past. You can't be, we're not electing a pastor-in-chief, we're electing a commander-in-chief, and we can't expect our commander-in-chief to have the same qualities as our pastors. And I think most of the rank-and-file evangelicals have figured that out on their own. I think some of the leadership has been slow to